Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about risk budgeting. Now that you've studied risk tolerance, you know that your company is willing to take so much of risk. If it is willing to take risk, you need to divide that risk, you need to allocate that risk into multiple avenues. Like in that video, I told you that if you are willing to take 20% risk, divide your funds into such assets that the total of it, the total portfolio risk, comes down to 20%. Let's check the theory first. Risk tolerance focused on appetite for risk and what is and what is not acceptable. Risk budgeting quantifies and allocates the tolerable risk. Now it is quantifying and it is allocating or dividing that risk. It forces risk trade-offs and supports a culture in which risk is considered as a part of all key decisions. Basically, whatever decision you are taking, ye jo risk tumne dhunda, quantify kiya, you have to consider that. You can use standard deviation, beta, value at risk, etc. to quantify and allocate the risk. Now, this standard deviation, beta, wagera jo hai, that is a part of our chapter which we'll be studying ahead. Let's check one example of risk budgeting. You want your sigma P. If you remember, sigma P kya tha? Standard deviation of the portfolio, which is the total risk, to be 20%. Basically, now you have quantified. Risk budgeting ka first step kya tha? Quantify karna hai. So now you have quantified 20%. Now you can divide this risk by investing in. So equity mein 40% dal do, real estate mein 20 dal do, bonds mein 40 dal do. These are just examples, but what you are trying to do is you are trying to allocate this risk. Now this is known as allocation. So three steps. First step, quantified. Second step, divided. Basically, third step mein allocation ho gaya. Now sigma P is equal to 20% by selecting appropriate investments with such standard deviation and correlation that sigma P matches to 20%. If you remember from portfolio risk and return part 1 and 2, what you have studied is something like this. Sigma P is equal to root of WA sigma A, WB sigma B and so on. That bada wala formula. There, one thing was sigma and one thing was correlation between A and B. Basically, you select such stocks or you select such investments with such standard deviation and such correlation that your final answer comes down to 20%. So this is known as risk budgeting. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida and subscribe to eKida.